Following a 104-83 win in the opening round of the SAC tournament, we're joined by the head coach, Brian Good. Coach, your opening statement as your team is officially moving on to the next round of the SAC tournament.
I mean, you know, that was kind of what we – step one, you know, in a conference tournament. You know, you got to just take care of the first one. You can't get worried about, you know, where it may lead to and how many you got to win and all that and who you got to beat. You had to take care of Mars Hill, and I – thought we did a really good job of that today. I thought I don't think the field goal percentage numbers are indicative of how well we defended, maybe from about 10 minutes in until maybe about 7 minutes to go. I think they made a ton of shots down the stretch when it was kind of already over. So I thought it was a really long stretch. We defended really well today. And obviously you got to be pretty happy with 26 assists and 5 turnovers.
Those two games to close out the regular season against Wise and Catawba, what adjustments did you guys make coming into today that you feel like your team did much better?
Yeah, to be honest, we just both those games and two things. One, we couldn't address because it was a player and not having RJ. Mm-hmm. It just kind of changed things a little bit. But, you know, we've just been trying to work really hard on being just a little bit better of on the ball, not needing so much help, and which leads to open shots. I thought in both those two games, and even the Anderson game here, I thought we really struggled guarding the basketball, and I thought today I saw a lot of improvement.
You're the second highest scoring team in the league. How has your offense evolved from, say, the first game of the season to right now? What's been the biggest part of the growth offensively?
Well, I think I think the biggest part is just that we've become very three-point shot reliant. I mean, I think you can look and tell that about us. The truth of it is when we shoot it at, you know, 44% or better, we're going to have a pretty good day offensively. And thankfully we've done that enough over the year. I think that's kind of – I don't know that I anticipated back in November being that reliant on the three, but, it's kind of – I think it kind of came about really when Quantre went down and we really lost all – you know, we didn't have a post player anymore with Trez already gone and then Q's gone. And so it was like, all right, how are we going to win games? And I think as we've gone on from there, that's been a big part of what we're doing. And – the only bad thing about that is, you can die with the three as well. Live and die with the three, and hopefully we'll keep living.
Five guys in double figures today. Can you just speak on their performances and how you feel like they played together at points?
Yeah, I mean, again, 26 assists, and I'm sure Hugh did a great job on that, giving those out. But still, that's really good, 26 assists. We got, I think as a basketball team, we've looked our best when we've had a stat sheet that looks like this, like just four or even five guys in double figures. And then I think, I think maybe there was a stretch where we were a little too dependent on CO and Cotty, I think you become a little, one or two dimensional, you become a little easier to defend. And I thought today we shared it really well. We made the easy play and it led to some good looks. And then obviously we had some guys shoot the ball pretty well.
Destin Clark didn't score, but he had 5 assists, 4 rebounds, and a guy that just can impact the game in other areas. And as a freshman, especially coming off the bench along with Andreas, what type of production and how important has Destin been to your team, especially recently?
Yeah, well, obviously with Rashard out, he's had to increase his minutes. I thought on Wednesday he played like a freshman. I think he had 4 or 5 turnovers and got a little bit hurried. And today I thought his pace that he played with is how he plays. And if he just doesn't get hurried, he makes really good decisions. He'll throw the ball to the open guy. He doesn't necessarily always look to score, but I think we've seen that he can in certain situations. But I thought today he was really trying to find the next guy to get an open shot. And, those were, you know, those were big minutes, and a lot of them, you know, 23 might have been his season high there. So he did a great job of kind of allowing us to keep doing what we're doing with even a guy down today.
We know you mentioned, of course, how much you guys miss RJ. Do you know the status of him going into Monday yet, or is it still up in the air?
I think it's still up in the air, you know. I think we'll obviously we're getting close if we're not there already, and I'm not so sure, you know. The one thing about RJ, obviously we miss him on the court, but you know, we miss his voice and his enthusiasm, and he hasn't been able to do that the last couple games either. So we've missed that as much as anything. So I know that part of it. I heard him a lot today, so that part of it's coming back for sure.
Early thoughts on Carson Newman, next opponent Monday?
Yeah, I mean, we've just got to – we've got to do a better job of cracking their zone and getting better looks. We just at their place, we just didn't. We just didn't get enough good ones. And then I thought we came into it kind of geared to do some things defensively, and I just didn't think we guarded their perimeter guys very well. I thought we let them get really in a groove for 40 minutes. Davis, Brennigan, and Dwyer just kind of took it to us. So we're going to have to do a better job there if we're going to be able to go up there and get one.
All right, Coach, congrats on the win today, though, and best of luck.
Thank you.